If you're wondering why it sounds like I'm addressing children in the following clip, it's because it's from my YouTube Dry Land Drills and Skills playlist on teaching the Peekaboo Penguin position to children.
We're going to work on the Peekaboo Penguin position today, and Peekaboo Penguin is going to help me out with this, aren't you? Yep, sure I am. Let's start by standing in our Peekaboo Penguin position. So just like Peekaboo Penguin, his wings are stuck to his sides, right? See, I can't remove his wings. They are super glued to his sides. So we're gonna stand up and pretend to be a penguin. Feet together, wings super glued to your sides. If you don't wanna be a penguin, you can be a soldier. So it's the same thing. You stand like a soldier, all right? Arms at your sides, just tighten all of these muscles, squeeze your glutes, stand up tall. So tall and straight and strong. If you have the perfect peekaboo penguin position when you're swimming on your back, it makes swimming on your back a whole lot easier. All right, so now we are going to do this lying down. I have a pull buoy, this is for kids. All right, this is the perfect size for a child. Also, when I do this sometimes with my students, I have them lie down on their back and I put this under their head, it puts their head in the perfect position, okay? For me, it doesn't really put my head in the perfect position. Okay, but you're gonna have, if you have this, or get a pillow or something, just put it under their head. See, my head is still too, it's not right because I'm looking up at the ceiling, and really the perfect head position is when your chin is down a little bit so you can see your feet, and you're gonna lift your feet and tighten all of those muscles. Super glue your wings to your sides. Oh my goodness. So when you're in the water, alright, when you're doing this in the water, you're floating on your back in your perfect peekaboo penguin position, your head, you're going to know that your head is in the perfect position because your chin is just touching the water. Alright, so again, just like this, you can start if you're in the water, you look up at the ceiling, and then if you just drop your chin a little bit, like about there, where your chin is just touching the water and you can see your feet, that's the perfect peekaboo penguin position.
Have your students try the peekaboo penguin position on land, just as I'm doing in this next clip, to the count of 10.
We're gonna do it to the count of 10, all right? So get your wings super glued to your sides, all right? Drop your chin a little bit just so you can see your feet, lift your feet, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, I didn't really mention, but you really should point your toes too when you do this.
Floating in your peekaboo penguin position. Hold on, put your feet up, look at the ceiling, slowly push off, and peekaboo penguin. Belly up, good. Feet together. Let's do it again. Okay, let's try it again. Remember to keep your feet together, Gael. Wings at your sides, feet together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Chin down a little. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. And roll over. Okay, so after, we're gonna do it again, and then what you're gonna do to stand up, you're gonna roll over to stand up. So do that right now, just roll over. Roll over. Okay, or roll forward, like that, okay? So let's do this again. Float in your peekaboo penguin position, and then after I count to 10, then you stand up. You either roll over or you roll forward to do that. So head back, look at the ceiling, push off in your peekaboo penguin position. Good, here we go. 1, feet together. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, chin down, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now roll over, good. Look at the ceiling, slowly push off, your peekaboo penguin position. Now let's just make sure that we got everything just right. So your chin, just want it down just a little bit. Keep your head exactly there. Keep your belly up. Always encourage your students to try their best, so make sure that their feet are together and the toes are pointed, the arms are super glued to the sides, the belly is up and kind of out of the water, and the chin is just touching the water.
Teaching tips. Number one, first a warning. Even when you tell your students to push off from the wall slowly, you're still gonna get some speed demons who wanna push off hard and fast. So be prepared, because if you're not expecting it, their head will collide with your face. Number two, the best way to get them to push off from the wall slowly is to tell them to slowly push off like an astronaut floating through space. It works every time. Number three, it's a good idea to tell your students to hold their breath when they push off from the wall. That way, if they submerge at the start of the skill, which is common, especially if they push off too hard, they'll avoid the inevitable water up the nose. Number four, the correct head position is essential to pull off this skill successfully. When the child puts their head back too far where their chin is pointing up toward the ceiling, this causes the feet to sink. But if the head position is just right, the feet will remain at the surface. That is, if all the other parts of the skill are executed properly and in tandem. And finally, number five, once your students can successfully and independently execute the back glide to the count of 10, then they'll be ready to add kicking to this skill.